On December 10th, 2020, a large space strike force descended from the stars to attack the joint human and rib spaceports in American territory. Its aim? To bring a world to its knees. Thousands died in one of the most devastating defeats of the war thus far. But it was not just simply a sudden attack. It was the culmination of ages of research and planning. This attack on Earth would be the first blow in a wave of attacks across the Sol system as the space pirates seek to carve out an empire. On that day, the planning was over, and a storm was about to break. First, the pirate fleet would destroy important human fleet units, thereby preventing their space forces from interfering with the pirate conquest of the nearby star systems and Federation territory, and to enable them to conquer the Asian region of Earth without interference. 4 battleships destroyed, 4 damaged, and 13 more major spaceships destroyed or seriously damaged. In return, only 29 of the space pirate craft were lost. They broke off and proceeded back on course. They're conquering Malaysia. Those bastards. They were waiting for us to make our move.
It's not just that. They've also appeared in the South China Sea and sunk one of our main warships. They're invading Thailand, Malaysia, Myanmar, and even the Philippines as we speak. They've landed at Bataan Island and are endangering local forces there. And one of their carriers is just about to land near Manila. Facing Thailand is not simply the pirates, but also deep-rooted BRES agents. They are led by some guy named Red Star. The Red Order of Siam has stormed the Thai Parliament in Bangkok. Oh, it's not over yet. Not by a long shot. The king has ordered any and all able-bodied citizens to grab anything resembling a weapon to fight back against the empire. And I mean everyone. Even Australian expats and tourists are joining the battle. Fancy that. There are rumors coming in of a Muay Thai wrestling family. Two girls on a summer break that allured the enemy with their looks and then took him out. There are even unconfirmed reports of a superhuman. Space-time rupture. Something's coming through. It's him, Horatio.
Groovy. Are we there yet?
Ibis, you're back. Finally. Where have you been?
I've gone through the Flash Portal again.
Oh, how long have you been in there?
I make it 2 years. It was a galactic-wide quest.
What? It's only been 10 days since you left here.
I returned to the Dracogian skies, then joined the Radical Aces, went to a chasm, got attacked by helicopters, took part in rallies, was on the run, gliding through canyons, battling alongside a 3-foot ninja, and now I'm back at last.
Oh boy, you have been through a lot, buddy. You need to get rested and recharged, because there's a lot to do up in Asia right now.
The government of Taiwan has been completely overthrown. The constitutional monarchy has been abolished, and the nation has become a communist state under the new name of the Democratic Republic of Siam. Currently, only 10 of the remaining Thai royal family have made it safely to the Philippines, where the Filipino government has allowed the royal family to stay there and create a government in exile.
Well, that's encouraging. Not exactly what I had in mind when my squadron was given break time after everything that happened last year. But don't worry, we are planning to do something about that. It'll involve something out of this world and out of this time. Yes, we've enlisted the help of one of the IUN's leading physics experts, Dr. Juana Barbara Silva. From her research facility in Santiago, she has helped us time travel more efficiently, and her team has given us more intel on how our enemy works.
Well, at least New Zealand is out of the dark for now, courtesy of our squadrons. But things are heating up in the US, as you may have heard. It's the former president's military They've launched a riot attack on the capital.
The tangerine pulpitine is at it again.
Unbelievable.
He's called in Confederate and neo-Nazi paramilitary, backed by private military contractors. They're trying to occupy the capital.
We must wipe out the large hostile force advancing on Washington, D.C., no matter what. All aircraft, you are clear to engage. Take the bastards down. Where's the damn National Guard?
Even worse, he's not a president anymore. He identifies as the Emperor. And there were signs of the Hoplon. That mysterious, pixelated UFO. Jane Phoenicia. She's still alive? In response to this, the American forces are upgrading big time. Our friends in Wolf Squadron are converting to Spirit of Dragon Starfighters, training for the Starfleet is on the double, and the mission to the new star system of New Olympus is getting underway. The Interstellar Expeditionary Plan is still underway after all. And I know, I've been in Raven Station watching it all unfold, escorting the starships out of Earth's orbit.
Colonel. Yes, General. Confederate rebels have been extremely active below the new Mason-Dixon line. We are going to need everything you and the Air Battle Force have. We have been gathering intelligence on this new Q force the National Guard encountered. We will ready your new fighters as soon as possible. Yes, sir.
And with our NREB allies, our forces plan to expand even further into the stars. Into the battle, into the war. There are indeed some long-term plans in play. But back down to Earth for a second. So now, we're heading to Vietnam. Indeed, my orders are to travel back to the place it once was.
What? You just went.
Omega, Wolf, and I will join Stanislav and his team. We are going to strike this red star and his BRES agents where they're at their most vulnerable. The past.
That has potential to go so wrong.
Yep, we are maintaining a low profile. We're calling it Operation Seaman. We are to meet in the center of Saigon and await further instructions. My squadron is going to be migrating back to Africa again. We're wheels up in a few hours. It's going to be a wild ride. All right, gentlemen. We're finally here in beautiful Vietnam. Now make sure you're all practicing social distancing around here. Oh, hello. We got a call from Commander Langham.
Since we can buy Rolexes here for a fiver and lunch for 50 cents, we are standing in the world's largest pound shop. You should have no trouble buying wings at the local aircraft market.
Ah, I love the smell of money in the morning. No,
I've bought this. It's a handy Russian twin engine and basically the AK-47 of combat helicopters. Rugged, simple, easy to repair. It's built specifically for combat in rough terrains and haphazard conditions. It will be for whatever they throw at us. Perfect.
I've gone completely native. I've bought this. It's a classic AH-1S Cobra.
Indeed, over 1,100 of these have been built, and it is great to liberate the people than, well, the American tanks that support it, for instance. Ramos and I have got this, which is a chopper. We're good to go.
104 Squadron, this is Colonel Ba Sing Se, Vietnam People's Air Force. I will be your CO for this op.
You'll now attempt to achieve in a few days what the Americans failed to achieve in 10 years. Get from the south of Vietnam to the north. You will help the Vietnamese army march against the space pirates from here in Saigon to Haiphong City near the Chinese border, which is 1,000 miles.
Alright! I'm going through it.
Be warned, Ramos. This is going to be a tough one. The front lines are seething cauldron of barely organized chaos. Death trap for the inexperienced.
This is it. 1,000 miles.
And we're off!
Attack! Don't be my duck! You entered Dintre! Come forth and deliver!
You have your mission objectives. I wish you luck.
Whoa! This is such a melee! I've been flying a chopper for 2 years, and I've never seen anything like this! Just improvise! Garuda 1, firing rockets! Oh, look out! I kept going the wrong way! Oi! too close for comfort?
We're leaving Saigon.
I'm glad we didn't get jets. This is better. Gerudo, 2 firing rockets. I just like to blow things up.
This is terrifying. Get no thought of for fuck's sakes. You're going the wrong bloody way.
That's right, how do I do? That's all, some time for ban, both time.
Thanks for waiting for me, Nicholas Cage and his boyfriend.
I did. Think, remote always waits for me, so I'll wait for him.
I thought you were behind us. Where are you going now?
Oh no, what if we have to finish the whole journey without him?
Aww. Time to roll up my sleeves and have some lunch.
These choppers are quite a common sight on the front lines, from Africa to Eurasia and certain places. They're seen with various members of insurgencies on them carrying AK-47s and RPGs.
You see, Wedgetail, this is a chopper that made its name here in Asia, the US, Thailand, and Korea.
Work for one bloody minute!
It's getting worse. So, you may have a problem with your misreporting agent. Faster! Faster! Just a dozen more miles to Dalat. Just a minute. You should have bought a more powerful chopper.
Nope, not admitting it yet. I'm still going.
I'll go check it out. See if it gets choppier.
Excellent work, Garuda. That was an impressive start.
We've reached the latch.
I've made quite an appetite.
What a country. It's kind of ironic, really. Setting our goals aside for an even greater threat.
I am the most miserable human alive.
You know what, mate? You shouldn't have laughed at remorse when he came in. Because now he's got revenge on us by ordering set menu B. Would you like vodka with snake blood or vodka with snake bile to go with your snake meal?
I'd take the blood, because... bile...
Oh yeah. Yeah, those Vietnamese people... They're really good at defending against invaders, so why should aliens be an exception?
Makes sense. They do have the best ground advantage.
Yep. Yeah. After this, it's got to be apparently Mozambique for me. Halfway through.
I wish I knew where I was headed, at least.
Garuda team, this is Colonel Sinsei. The ground forces are continuing their march north. Keep up that fire support.
Name one upside to this, James. One upside!
Well, you're not hot anymore.
Oh wait, there is an upside. Alamur's Taliban helicopter has decided it likes rain even less than me.
It's good for you. Stop whining. I'll bet you anywhere you want to go, I'll ride my Cobra tonight.
I hate you.
Offering my brain and bomb. Don't move you.
Cock, this is a massive old cock. That brain reason is moving noise on my windshield.
The leader is under fire. Can anyone assist?
I'm being supported by a mercenary in a Russian chopper. Let's see if I can pay him with some wet out of the pockets. It's all wet in this chopper. My dog has gone all soggy.
Garuda team, you've got more Taranis allies on station.
Alamur, we've got reinforcements on approach. Some say that his politics are terrifying, and that there's an airport in Russia named after him. All we know is he's not Sea Fury, but he is Sea Fury's communist comrade.
Sea Fury 4-1 to Garuda team. Now we need to receive, entering a top run. Garuda team, all ground targets in the vicinity destroyed. You are clear.
Prior to starting off, Alamur was presented a gift by Remorse in the form of a scale model of a Spanish galleon, which he quickly discovered he would have to transport on the rest of the journey on the back of his hide. Despite this, all three of us set off from Nha Trang without issues, and found ourselves liberating Tai Hoa, Quy Nhon, Quang Nai,
and Tom Key without incident, eventually arriving in Hoi An, which the Remorse described as Vietnam's version of Savile Row.
Commencing strike operations. Squadron attack.
I signed up to fly space planes and fighter jets, not boats. Let's not get bogged down. We are here, and we've got to help the Allies in the rivers and find Red Star's hideout. There is a small problem, though. The rainy season has arrived with a vengeance. Calling Skipper Omega. Nice to have you here, no time for pleasantries. We've got a big obstacle in the way, and this can do everything other than go it alone. Into the reeds, handle throttle, through the salad. 200 yards. What a victory for the Antique. We're through. Open the taps. Oil pressure's excellent. I believe we are boating. Let's raise a class or 10 to the ghost blast. I've got a drink fridge. Here we go. Paperwork's done. Don your red berets, guys. We're roaring into the NAM. Follow me. I know this looks dodgy. Weeds! Oh, please, God, no. It's like English river boating. Why did we turn off the delta? Let's go. Watch out. Thanks, Wolf. The nav's gone. Dodgy bloody well so far, hasn't it?
Human forces, this is the Kyberdine Expeditionary Force. We are here to support you on your northern march.
Look out, Elmer.
Whoa! I can fix that.
See those mountains up there, James? We're going up there.
Once that was done, all three began making their way towards their next destination, with our route taking us via the Hoi An mountain pass, where Remorse finally began enjoying his chopper.
This is great!
Going in for guns. It keeps getting better.
Eventually, when we reached the city of Hoi, whereupon Alamar spent his time within the group's hotel fixing his model ship of his, unaware that his colleagues were spray-painting his chopper and even roping in the local restaurant staff to help us, paying him back for breaking it in the first place.
I told you he'd be furious. Can he really not organize a bloody formation better than this?
I told him Chef did it.
Did he believe you?
Nope.
Funny that.
It was week 6 of our campaign, and the finish line was still so far away. What's more, the combat was getting worse.
You can tell we're getting close to the north. I found a new pathway, but everyone else found it too. Holy cow, it's a motorway for water lorries. Reaching home for motorboats, it's the Forest of Assassins.
We are approaching target airspace. Space pirate aerial fleet in attack range.
Neptune frontier. Tuntoi Kuntonto. Alien fighters designating targets now.
Attack wing Zom. Focus fire on the deck. Attack wing Demon Star. Flank. Target space pirate aircraft.
To make matters worse, the combat was more mental than ever. After breakfast, we set about for Heilong City. The journey took us through more scenic landscapes, even stopping in a rural village after we got lost. Eventually though, it really looked like we were about to make it. With just 50 miles to go, Almer went berserk.
Just a maverick. He'll pay the price.
Oh no! I'm breaking down!
Happily, what's plowed on? And without his hammer, this little approach to pretty much everything, we'll have the chopper mended in a jiffy.
I am boldly going where no American chopper has gone before.
Hey, Long City!
Yes! We made it! Yay! My D your hide, you little buffalo, you.
We've just gone from the south to the north of Vietnam. Fantastic. I cannot believe all three choppers made it.
Well done, God of the Flight. We've done it. Heilong City is back in our hands. The territorial integrity of Vietnam remains. The space pirates will taste no victory in the beautiful country of Vietnam.
The Raven Station shuttle just dropped off supplies and personnel to Maputo. Our offensive is about to begin. We must airlift some of our troops to help them with this one. You guys, thanks for saving my life out there. Good to be a part of your team. Don't worry, Lieutenant. I'll come visit you after the war.
Oh, really? Bravo! Jump into the old ride and stay in the country. Relive the old times.
What, dig a hole in the garden, fill it with water, and then get your gamekeeper to shoot at us all day?
That's the thing I really don't understand about you, Captain. I mean, you're a professional soldier, and yet sometimes you sound as if you very well haven't enjoyed soldiering at all.
Well, you see, George, I did quite like it. Back in the old days when the prerequisite of an African campaign was that the enemy should, under no circumstance, be allowed to carry guns. Even spears made us think twice. The people we liked to fight were only 2 feet tall and armed with dry grass.
And come off it now, sir. What about the second Sierra Leone Civil War last year, for Pete's sake?
Oh yes, that was a nasty one. Several hundred terrorist soldiers armed to the teeth with kiwi fruit and guava, huh?
After the battle was over, instead of taking prisoners, we simply made a huge fruit salad.
Well, I was in that war too. We had support from the Ashling Lotus. And we still are achieving great victories, even when she is far gone, wherever she is. Oh well.
Professor Lasortich, the one that her company hires, is still in Freetown in Laboratory TG-20.
More work to do. More flying to places. Jolly, jolly, jolly.
Also, I know there's an Italian squadron armed with nuclear bombs here. They do not attack unless I approve. The heat's already pretty bad as is.
Ouroboros was now on the verge of defeat once and for all. And we had several ideas to bring about their end. Windhover proposed we should build a plane that's also a mothership. I wanted to fire a rocket into space. But then we decided that what we should actually do, because neither of those things were ambitious enough, was end Ouroboros in Africa once and for all. It was a big job, not the sort of thing we could achieve in 20 minutes with a couple of fighters and a bit of idle chit-chat in between. No, we were going to need a full campaign, a full special operation. So now, while my friends held the initiative in Vietnam, I took some Tirana's forces on a small-scale campaign to the poverty-stricken but beautiful country of Mozambique. Unfortunately, having agreed that we would save the African continent by helping out Mozambique against the insurgents, we couldn't agree on how this might be achieved, so we ended up with different solutions. I came up with a surplus Douglas C-47 Skytrain. That was clever. Or allegedly not as clever as what a mate came up with, because he reckoned for the first time in his entire life he's made a sensible decision. He went with a Symaster's CV-62H Ranger hardbody for its tons of space in the back for supplies. Kahu 1, meanwhile, hadn't been clever at all. He decided to bring a helicopter because none of his fighter jets were able to make it to Africa in time. Once we modified our planes to carry out supply runs, Mozambique Command told us we had to go out to sea, using local methods we didn't really understand.
Let's go! Get moving, you idle sods! Alright, I think this might be working. Oof, we've snagged something! Behold the sparkling treasure of the seas! Alright, we got 8 insurgent boats. Gotta be careful. If we go out too far, the wind will blow us onto the shore. Or we just might miss it and end up in Madagascar or Somalia.
Eventually, the loading was complete and we were ready. Time to save the nation.
Right, forward in of saving the people. This is it. It is with great pride and humility that I accept this award. Man, I wish the air conditioner would work in this thing. Alright, lads, let's get out in the grapes.
Our mercy mission would take us through the city of Maputo to the tiny village of Bingo, and eventually further up north. However, a few miles later, the peaceful airspace ran out.
Galaxy to Hunter team, patching you through to the IUN force comm frequency. Things are getting busy. Weapons and radar all of operational, Jupiter. Think we can afford to share a bottle of red at the end of today?
I'm armed and ready.
This is General Elizabeth, callsign Wild Boar of the IUN force. To anyone in this net, we need immediate fire support.
This is Hunter team. Detachment from the Scion Volunteer Corps receiving you. Hang tight, we're moving in.
Really? Mercenaries? Fine. Hunter, we're designating targets of opportunity.
Not exactly the reinforcements we asked for.
Outcome.
Those are missiles in the mountains.
I've just been targeted by a stinger. Should I worry?
Oh, mate, you're gonna be targeted by more than one. Cargo One's under fire.
Cargo just fell out your door, Cargo.
Wide interference present. I can't really track anything outside of the BKO. Does anyone know what's up with that?
None of me. There's a lot of communications around. It's damn hard to keep any front stable without comms, I'll tell you that much.
Sir, some of the local soldiers think I was best. Would you agree? Bouldering in the Amazonian rainforest, there are tribes of Indians as yet untouched by civilization that have more convincing ammo loading skills than yours. Oh, thank you very much, sir.
Cock. That was going well. Garuda 1 reporting engine trouble.
What's the news, slowly?
I need to wait and restart.
So he's staying behind. Hey, Humphrey! What do you want, Godfrey? I'm a little occupied here. This bubble here is some real good stuff.
We have the strength to win this.
Hunter, we need those tanks dealt with.
All armor targets splashed. Why don't you give the rebel troops some wiggle room?
Woohoo!
Good to be flying with you again.
Our lieutenant sneering, Joe. Move his troops with those toxic positions eliminated. These mercenaries might save our asses, yeah.
Okay, that's a mode of confidence for most. By my rough reckoning, because my airspeed and my GPS aren't working, we haven't much left to go. Why do they have to make it so bloody far away?
And the one drive, Ruder leader's got engine trouble, and he's very unpleased.
You bastards! I hate you! All of you! You utter bastards!
Just find an airstrip to land and I'll come pick you up. I'm happy to have your cargo on board, but I'm not happy to wait up with you all the time.
This thing would have made it if I've had the support. You complete moron.
I hope you get Bilharzia up the ball sack.
Right, that's it. He's asked for it.
Are destroyed. The insurgents are helpless now.
Scion AWACS Galaxy to all International Union elements. Advised to cease engagement. Shotocracy is disengaging on no factor.
Good God! We're alive!
You think those mercs accept tips? It'll take more than that to convince me.
Hunter team, RTB. We're reporting similar successes up and down Africa. If Jupiter keeps cracking up kills like that, we're gonna need a bigger offshore account.
Oh, Elmer, you would not believe what I've just been through in Mozambique.
Absolute hell? Was it?
Well, it was an absolute hell to get through weather-wise, but at least the deliveries were on time. Did you hear that Operation Seaman reached its climax?
Enough with the innuendo joke, please.
But Ivis just came back. We just found the Red Star criminal. After all this searching, we finally got him. And the old timer and his P-38 are coming in too. He's been chasing him for a while as well.
Well, Task Force Athena is coming to this time to take out Red Star and his BRES allies. Okay, so we have acquired enough information to find out where he is. I'm just hoping that Terramanta warship isn't too much of a problem. Yes. They also say that Omega, you arrived back in their time a bit too early. So, your Operation Seaman reaches climax a little too early? Oh, it happens to the best of us. Anyway, let's get ready for the next fight.
Another wave of future fighters. The other two waves still haven't returned.
X-ray flight, this is US Forward Air Control. Task Force Athena has explained the situation and has assigned us to be your command for this mission.
God, Master, remember when we landed at Tokyo and had to walk our asses down to the Saigon hills?
Operation is a go.
But I'll be fucked if I'm letting the majority of the boys from the 38 fucking fly.
We got a message from Athena. Wait until Jade Hydra lets out a warning before destroying its turret.
Watch out! Low-level bombers coming in from the east.
It's a sneak attack. They must have snuck in under the radar.
X-ray 1, it is imperative that you destroy the bomber wing attacking our positions ASAP. We can't take much more punishment.
There they go. The convoy looks like it's trying to form up onto fire.
It's a scatter moment.
We need to take that pressure off them.
Oh, yep, I found you.
I can't provide support until the bombers have driven off. For the moment, you're on your own.
These tangos make good target practice. You looking for explosive? Right here.
Let's go. We've got to save the Captain Fury. It's not something I thought I'd ever say. The Sky Soldiers were shot down trying to reach you. Their target is still there.
That's what I'm talking about!
It looks like they're safe. Good work, you men. What now, Vietnam Control?
We've got enemy advance units moving toward the village. They're working with artillery and air cover to pin the Athena Time Force in their base.
Oh my god, I hate base armor so much.
If we don't help out, they'll be trapped when the main space pirate force arrives. Well, we can't have that sort of thing.
The Athena Control is reporting no more artillery fire.
Enemy armor is advancing on their position. Let's try to slow them down.
The enemy armor has stopped its advance. At least what's left of it.
I'd say the 7th is safe for now. Where do you need us?
The main cluster is helping the other groups on the ground. Why do you want friends?
This area is under control. Move on to the next. Tally, enemy strato fortress.
They're not one of ours. They've been using that to infiltrate air corridors. Shoot it down for all it's done.
MAB-52 is down. Coming up on the swamp.
Right, well, I'm gonna make a bound for the objective.
They're in the trees.
Warning, warning. Large presence detected at low altitude.
What the hell is that?
Visual on an airship. That bloody annoying Terramanta.
Strike first! Strike hard! No mercy!
Continue air support. 0.50 meters.
Alright, that ought to slow them down. Airship is down, push forward.
Free of charge, courtesy of Ghost Squadron.
No, just play some fungi sticks, don't worry about it. It's fine.
Oh yeah, what do they do?
You're needed at the refinery, Athena, if you're up to it. We don't want to leave that for the space pirates to use.
That won't be a problem.
We freed the ferry. Second objective complete.
They have the keys to taking down this Sigma machine. Alright, I'm impressed. How much more was still in that place?
Enough that they're regretting not getting their hands on it.
It looks like the space pirates are getting into base proper.
Confirmed, we need you to provide cover for the land and river raid routes.
It looks like there's armor going around the region trying to cut off.
Yeah, but there's an entire army on us.
The mic clusters are capturing the main towers.
Gate hydrocyded. That thing captured the aerofighters.
Starfighters. Come on, Red Star. All the reign of terror will come to an end. It's time to pay for what you've done in all those times. Your way of new skills on the field.
This is madness. We've got to stop your time traveling.
And you would know about madness, wouldn't you? You talk of this experiment being suicidal as if you value your life, but when you send your men to interfere in my revolution, the experiment's been almost complete, and you sign your own death warrant.
We've got fresh hostiles heading for the fortress, sir. We'll have to split our forces. Heroes, you with me. Not us, Zephyros. Help out the soldiers in the fortress. Aye, aye, Captain. Roger that. Hurry up! It's sending the message! Quickly! At last, it's over for you, Red Star.
Then it's over for all of us. Activate the Sigma machine.
What the hell? My time distortion detector's going off! It's a time corridor. We're directly under it. All aircraft, drop your altitude, quickly!
I thought it was control.
Mayday! Get out of there! Pull out! X-ray 3, get back there and...
There's a portal in the sky, fall back! In.
This is not good! Go Squadron, can you hear me? Go Squadron, can you hear me? Mike Luss! What the hell? Red Star tried to time travel in a faulty prototype machine. He tore a hole through time, which pulled them in. He sealed his fate when he stepped in it.
They did it, didn't they?
Incoming transmission. As BRES's Vietnam stronghold falls, we detected a transmission about a geostabilizer in Iceland. Return to base and disable this device while BRES is reeling.
We are looking at enormous damage. We must exterminate it now.
Do not worry. We have a plan. They take command of Rostelecom.
To be crossed, we need to delay it all.